Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. Is there life outside of the Earth? Can other life forms exist out there? These have been some of the questions that space agencies like NASA have been trying to answer for years now. Ever since the birth of space exploration in 1957, these questions still remain unanswered. Space agencies like NASA and the ESA have been sending probe after probe to find out more about other planets. These same probes are always on the lookout for any sort of life form that may be out there. However, it was discovered that if they were to answer the question about life being interplanetary, they needed a stronger instrument that would be powerful enough to detect and study other planets' atmospheres. Now, with the James Webb Space Telescope having started operations, it has proved to be what they're looking for. The James Webb Telescope has once again proved that it can detect life forms on exoplanets. But how can this be? Before we continue, make sure you smash that like button as hard as you can and subscribe to our channel for nothing but the latest updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, space, technology, and so much more. Before we can dive into how the James Webb Space Telescope can detect these life forms on exoplanets, let's first find out a little about habitable exoplanets. It is said that life can exist in the solar system where there is the presence of liquid water. This means that the subsurface aquifers on Mars or the oceans on Jupiter's moon, Europa, have the possibility of supporting life. However, it's not that easy to find the evidence. This is because it is hard to land there and acquire some physical samples for testing. However, most astronomers believe there is a high possibility of life on the planets that orbit other stars. They all say that this is where life can possibly be found. According to some theoretical calculations, there are around 300 million potentially habitable planets in the Milky Way galaxy alone. Furthermore, there may be many more habitable Earth-sized planets that are within a range of 30 light-years from Earth, which in space means that they are next galactic neighbors. There have been 5,000 exoplanets discovered so far, with hundreds of them being potentially habitable. All these exoplanets have been discovered using indirect methods that measure the effects of a planet on its nearby star. Using this information, astronomers can determine the planet's mass and size, but nothing more. However, they would have to measure the biosignatures to find any evidence of life. Finding life is much more than just looking out for water. Astrobiologists have to study the starlight that comes into contact with a planet's surface or atmosphere. If the atmosphere or surface were transformed by life, the light might carry a small clue, the biosignature. When the Earth was just coming into existence, it had an atmosphere that had no oxygen. This was given the fact that there was the presence of simple, single-celled life. Earth had a very weak biosignature during this early era. However, 2.4 billion years ago, everything changed when a new family of algae was evolved. These new algae were using photosynthesis, which gives off free oxygen. This is pure oxygen that has not been chemically bonded with any other element. The Earth's atmosphere has been filled with oxygen since then, leaving a very strong and detectable biosignature on any light that passes through it. Once light bounces off the surface of a material or even passes through a gas, specific wavelengths of light are more likely to be trapped in the gas or material surface than others. This is the whole science behind different colors. Leaves appear green because of the chlorophyll, which is really good for absorbing light in the red and blue wavelengths. So when the light hits the leaf surface, the red and blue wavelengths are absorbed, leaving only the green light to bounce back. The pattern of the missing light is determined by the specific composition of the material that the light has interacted with. Astronomers can use this to learn about the composition of an exoplanet's atmosphere or surface. Theoretically, they could measure the specific color of the light that comes from a planet. With this method, astronomers can recognize the presence of some atmospheric gases that are associated with life, namely oxygen and methane. This is mainly because these gases leave particular signatures in light. Not only that, but it could also be used to detect whether there are some peculiar colors on the surface of a planet. For example, here on Earth, the chlorophyll and other pigments plants and algae use for photosynthesis capture particular wavelengths. These pigments lead to the production of a characteristic color that can be detected by using a sensitive infrared camera. This means that if you were to see this color reflecting off the surface of another planet somewhere, there might be chlorophyll on that planet. Astronomers would have to develop a powerful instrument to discover light from another planet. They would need to build something so powerful that it can even notice the slightest changes in the light coming from a potentially habitable exoplanet. And right now, they have a telescope that can do just that. This is the James Webb Telescope. Having begun its scientific operations and observations in early July 2022, the James Webb Telescope has already left the world stunned with its very first images. The telescope is so powerful, it has already proved itself during testing. During its first observation, the telescope took a reading of the spectrum of the gas giant exoplanet WASP-96b. According to this spectrum, the exoplanet had water and clouds. However, for a planet as large and hot as WASP-96b, it is unlikely that it can host any life. However, this observation has proven that the James Webb Telescope is powerful enough to capture even the faintest chemical signatures in the light coming from other exoplanets. The James Webb Telescope is soon going to face TARPIST 1E, which is a potentially habitable Earth-sized planet that is about 39 light-years away from Earth. Webb will look for biosignatures as it studies planets as they pass in front of their host stars, capturing starlight that filters through the planet's atmosphere. However, Webb was not designed to search for life, meaning that it is only able to scan a small number of the nearest worlds that have the potential to sustain life. Not only that, but it can also detect some of the changes in the atmospheric levels of carbon dioxide, methane, and water vapor. However, even though it will be detecting some of these changes to the gases that are there, the Webb telescope does not have the ability to detect unbonded oxygen, which is the strongest indicator of life. There are leading concepts for the future that are even more powerful, with space telescopes having plans to block the bright light of a planet's host star, revealing starlight that has been reflected back from the planet. This is the same concept as when you block the sunlight with your hand to see something or someone in the distance. Future space telescopes could use small internal masks or large external umbrella-like spacecraft to achieve this. Once the starlight has been blocked, it becomes easier to study the light bouncing off a planet. The space agencies are also developing three massive ground-based telescopes, which will be used to detect biosignatures from other planets. These are the Giant Magellan Telescope and the 30-meter telescope and the European Extremely Large Telescope. Each of these three telescopes is more powerful than the ones already being used here on Earth. And even though the Earth's atmosphere has the tendency to distort starlight, these telescopes will still be able to probe the atmospheres of the closest worlds for oxygen. Even if there were much more powerful telescopes in the future, astrobiologists could only detect robust biosignatures that have been produced by worlds that have been entirely transformed by life. However, there is one setback. Non-biological processes can also produce most of the gases that have been released by terrestrial life. A great example is how a cow and a volcano release methane. Photosynthesis produces oxygen, but so does sunlight when it splits the water molecules into oxygen and hydrogen. This means that astronomers are likely to record a false positive when they decide to look for alien life. To help rule them out, astronomers will have to study a planet of interest to determine whether it is geologic or atmospheric processes producing the biosignature. Feel free to let us know in the comment section below whether you think the James Webb Space Telescope will actually detect other life forms on exoplanets. Also, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe for nothing but the latest updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, space, technology, and so much more. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.